Okay, I wanted to take just a quick look at the Salomon Advanced Skin 12 set for 2019 because Salomon kind of totally redid the vest for this year, and it's one I've been looking forward to. I haven't really seen any videos just on its features. I haven't really used it too much yet, but I just wanted to take a look at what it's got built in so far, and runs for about $155, and basically it looks like they tried to shave a few ounces off of it and try and make it a little more akin to the Ultra Vest series that they have, which are very light. Now this one's an XL size, and it's about 10.5 ounces, so I think that's about 3 or 4 ounces lighter than the previous gen Advanced Skin 12 set. But of course, the Ultra Vests are, 3, 4, 5 ounces, so quite a bit lighter. But this has a little more capacity, and the big difference is you can put a hydration bladder in these vests and not in the Ultra Vest. But anyways, just to show you, the bottles are kind of different too. So this is the new bottle, and you can see it's a little more flat, wide and flat. I think even compared to the old Advanced Skin Vest, this is more flattened out, and but it still has the small opening at the top. And then here's the ones that come with the Ultra Vest, and so that has the bigger top. So these are a little more comfortable, but the nifty thing is if you want to use the wider top ones, one thing they did on this vest this year is they padded where the hard parts are on the soft bottles. So there's padding here at the top and then padding here at the bottom. So that's a pretty cool feature, I thought. This is the inside. It feels like pretty much the same material as before, that kind of open mesh. So anyways, on the front, so you've got the two slots for the soft bottles, and then there is a loop here to kind of hold them up in the sleeves. And it looks like it's big enough now where it'll fit whichever soft flaps you want to use, including the wide mouth ones. That loop will fit it. So you got one of those inside that comes with the little whistle here, as they always do. You got two slots up at the top here, and neither one's zippered, they're just open. And then each one has a bungee here. So, I mean, you guys have to tell me, I don't know what all the features are for exactly on the Salomon vest, so comment below if you know more. But I mean, one thing I was thinking, you could loop like a buff through here and just have it there if you need to wipe your face or whatever. But the way this little slidey thing is, this hook attaches to, there's different spots on the vest with these thick loops here. They're not stretchy, and so that's what these hook into there. So again, I'm not exactly sure what you would do with that, but there it is to figure something out with. There is also, there's two little spots here, which on the Ultra Vest they are there to attach the pull quiver to. I don't have one of those. I'm not exactly sure if this is big enough. It looks like it's big enough to slide those hooks through, but so there's that. There's a loop here for your hydration bladder hose if you're using that. And then you have two big pockets like you have had before on other vests, but the difference is they kind of added two layers here with a zipper. So now you can use it either as the inside, or you can put stuff inside the zippered area, or both, I'm sure, some in each pocket. So I thought that was kind of a nifty way to do it. The front, the snaps are the way of fastening it, I should say, has been changed a little bit. So you still have those hooks on the little strings here, which can be adjusted as you want to. But then it's just this kind of W-shaped bungee, and hooks over here, and then you have a single barrel lock to tighten the whole thing down. So that seems to work pretty well so far in my limited experience. And then at the bottom here, so on the back, you'll see there's these two more of those bungees here. These ones are a little longer. So I think the idea is you could use these for poles. So you could put poles maybe across your back here. And again, they tighten up. There is, at the top, there's another bungee here. And I believe that, if I remember right, the old ones, you could run your poles diagonally across your back if they didn't fold up in the three pieces. So you could maybe stick the one end here and then loop the other end at the top here like you used to be able to do. You can unhook these from here. And then there's a spot on the front here. So you could run it like that. Maybe run your poles across the front if you wanted to. There's also another, you could move this attachment point over to this loop here if you wanted. So man, there's a lot of different options for doing, kind of customize the vest to however you want to use it, which is pretty cool, I think. So that's kind of everything on the front there. So around the back, you got more attachment points here if you want to change stuff up, a little loop there. So you kind of have the zip compartment here on the outside, and it's a pretty big compartment. It's very, very stretchy. It has this non-stretch cord up each side, and then the attachment point is just inside. This is the kangaroo pocket, so this runs all across the bottom of the pack, so in one side and out the other, kind of like the old one did. So you can definitely get to that from without taking the pack off, which is kind of nice. And then you have a little barrel lock in the side here, and you can tighten each the bottom part of the cord, and then the top part, you can kind of do those separately to snug that down. So the middle panel, you can see it's kind of a triangle, a taper, and on the inside bottom there is a pocket there, so right here. And so you got that to hold whatever. And then inside this compartment, there are two little hooks here that, not quite sure what those are for. I mean, looks like you'd hook a cord onto that for keys or odds and ends. So got something there. All right, so that's the big outer compartment. And then then you got several compartments that open from the top. So you got the main slot here, which would probably be for a hydration bladder. And actually, it does come with the insulation sleeve. This will fit, I believe, a 1.5 liter bladder that Salomon makes. And if you didn't want to use that, then it looks long enough that you could probably fit a 3 liter bladder in the back if that's what you were running. And there's a little hook at the bottom, at the top, to hang it up. So yeah, this is an XL vest. I would say they're running a little larger. So in the previous gen, Advanced Skin 12, I couldn't fit it at all. The largest size, which I think was an XL, was too small for me. I'm about a 42 inch chest. And that's kind of how the large fit in this new generation. So the XL does fit me in this one. So I would say they went up maybe one size from the previous gen, which is kind of nice for me as a bigger guy. So you got one long sleeve here anyways. Then you have a divider, and now you have another sleeve. So this is just a long sleeve. It goes down to about 3 inches from the bottom, and I don't know if you can see, but there's a blue strip there, and that's where your bladder hose would come out, and then you can run it through the side. There's an opening in the bag, and then it would run up through the pocket here and up to your up to that loop on the front of the vest. So yeah, one big sleeve here. This one has a mesh pocket at the top. It doesn't seal shut, but it's a slot there, and there's a key loop there. So I don't know, maybe you could stick a battery or something in there if you needed to. And yeah, so that's the, and then you have the third section, which is the zip pocket here. So a lot of areas to kind of customize your load that you're carrying. So yeah, that's just a quick look at the new vest. Just wanted to put that out there if you're thinking about getting one. And I'll be trying it out more this year, of course, and hopefully we'll be, maybe come back and do a review on how everything's working. So thanks for watching, and take care.